गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड द पोटेंशियोमीटर मैथड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ मेजरमेंट ऑफ लो रेजिस्टेंस. नाउ कमिंग टू द थर्ड मैथड, दैट इज केल्विन डबल ब्रिज मैथड. नाउ बेसिकली वॉट वी आर डूइंग इज वी आर एलिमिनेटिंग सम काइंड ऑफ एरर्स इन बाई यूजिंग दिस केल्विन डबल ब्रिज मैथड. वी आर हैविंग सम एरर्स लाइक कॉन्टैक्ट रेजिस्टेंस, रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ लीड एंड लेक ऑफ सेंसिटिविटी. These all factors are unsuitable for the measurement of low resistance. So the Lord Kelvin designed a bridge network which is called Kelvin double bridge method. Now coming to the diagram of this Kelvin double bridge method. So basically in this diagram we are having this X. Here it's a X. Okay, this X is a resistor under the test and this S is a standard resistance, and like in us this S is a standard resistance, or like in our previous case of potentiometer we have taken a two condition, which is like that the resistance of this S should be of order of the resistance under the test, and the second one is its current rating should be same, must be same or like or of higher current rating than the resistance X. These two resistors X and S are connected in series with a short link, this, and this short link is of lowest resistance which is possible. This capital P, Q and small p and small q are four known resistance. The resistance are non-inductive in nature. The current through this this circuit, this the blue one where R and S are connected, is connected to the battery source of having a low voltage and high current supply. There is a rheostat here and an ammeter connected in series with it. A galvanometer, sensitive galvanometer, is connected here across this dividing point of this capital P and capital Q, and in between of small p and small q. The ratio of this capital P and divided by capital Q is equals to small p and divided by small q. This should be like a general case to keep in mind for the balance, for getting the balance point of galvanometer. So this is the must condition of this bridge, that the ratio of P by Q is kept the same as small p by Q. These ratio are being valid until the galvanometer reads zero. Okay. This is a must condition. So in this case, what we are trying to do is we are applied the Kirchhoff voltage law in this arm and this arm. By getting the equations, we will get the equation which will give us the ratio of X by S, and finally we will get the X. And here is the current in the main supply. I is supplied to this R and capital I is supplied to the S. Here I is divided into two parts, I1 here in this branch and this I2 in the small part of this circuit. So by applying the Kirchhoff law in this circuit, we will be getting I1P minus of in a reverse direction, minus of I2 small p and minus of Ix, because the direction of this I2 and I is opposite of this I1. So we will get Ix will be equals to I1P minus of I2 small p. Similarly, we will apply the Kirchhoff voltage law in this arm also, FEDCK. We will be getting I1Q minus of Is and minus of I2Q. So from this we will get Is is equals to I1Q minus of I2Q. When we will divide this I1X by this equation Ix divided by Is, we will be getting our expression like this. X by S is equals to I1P minus I2 small p divided by I1Q minus of I2 small q. We will take the p as common from above side and q from the denominator. So we are having this I1 minus small p divided by capital P I2. In the denominator, we are having I1 minus small q divided by capital Q I2. So from the bridge balance condition, we have this capital P by capital Q is equals to small p by small q. By just cross multiplying it, we are having the small p by capital P is equals to small q by capital Q. So the term is equivalent in numerator and denominator, so this will get cancelled out. So finally we will get X by S is equals to capital P divided by capital Q. So we will get our value of unknown resistance X, which is equals to P by Q S. So this is the basic procedure of this Kelvin double bridge method. Here in this method, we have eliminated the resistance of the leads and we have just taken the four terminals P, Q, X and S as for the measurement of capital X. Now coming to the operation of Kelvin double bridge, practically it is slightly different from that we have described here. In practical case, we are going to have some kind of shunt resistance across our X, which is our unknown resistance. In a practical case, we are having capital P, Q and small p and small q are as known quantities and a fixed standard resistance and the temperature coefficient are also known. The resistances of all these four quantities are taken in such a way that the ratio get fulfilled. This capital P by capital Q is equals to small p by Q. Usually this p is taken as equals to small p and this q is taken to small q, so the ratio gets equal by 1 and 1. Okay, if the approximate value of X is unknown, then it is determined by the other principle like our voltmeter method and potentiometer method, like if we are going to have this approximate value of X. Now for the exact value of capital X, to find the precise value of X, we are going to shunt this X with the variable small r resistance. So basically our capital X will be equals to 1 by x, which is our unknown resistance, plus 1 by small r, which is a variable resistance shunted with our unknown resistance X. So basically our ratio turns to be out like this: capital X multiply by small r divided by small r plus X is equals to P by Q S. Here in a practical case, we are shunting our unknown resistance by some smaller resistance R. So in this above expression, we have our unknown resistance, which can be determined by the value of known capital P, Q, S and smaller R. So these measurements are also carried out with the supply current reversed, and the average value from the two observations can be taken out the correct value. This whole method is done to eliminate the errors due to thermoelectric EMFs. Okay, here in this case, the sensitivity of the bridge is determined by noting the smallest variation in our shunting resistance small r, which causes an observable deflection in the galvanometer. The difference in x for such variation of r can easily be calculated, which gives us the sensitivity of the bridge. So basically, by taking the value of small r in a shunting process, we are getting two types of method, like to eliminate two effects. First one is to eliminate the thermoelectric effect of EMF, and the second one, we are getting the sensitivity of the bridge. The ratio of this P and Q is made exactly to small P by Q by adjusting the lead resistance, which are used for the connections. Since these are included in the arms as well as the resistance of the coil of themselves, the ratio of these two can also be made independent of temperature to very close approximation by suitable proportioning of resistance to the copper leads. So in coming to the correction factor, now what we are taking in a correction factor is the connection lead, which is small r in our diagram. Here in a general case, we do not consider this small r resistance. So in a correction method, we are going to have this small r as a part of a numerical process. So finally, we will get our correction factor. Now coming to the correction factor, if the condition capital P by capital Q is equals to small p by Q cannot be very exactly fulfilled. So the total resistance of the link BC and the end connection of two resistor require consideration. So we have to consider the total resistance in the arm BC, which is carrying this contact lead resistance small r. Basically, our arm BC is a connection lead. So our I2 will comes out to be this is small r divided by whole resistance of the loop P plus Q plus R and multiply by the total current coming to the circuit. This is the current division rule, where for having I2 we are going to have this opposite arm resistance divided by the total resistance, that is P plus Q plus R multiply by total current coming in the circuit. So basically I2 will be equals to this R divided by P plus Q plus R multiply by this I. So we will substitute this I2 in our previous equation, like 3.3 and 3.4. We are going to insert this I2 value here in equation I1P minus I2 small p minus Ix, and the second equation I1Q minus I2Q minus Is. Now in correction factor, this small r is very very less than P plus Q, so we will eliminate this r from the denominator. So our I2 will be equals to R by P plus Q multiply by I. So by substituting this value of I2 in our previous equations, we will get this I1P minus of value of I2. Multiply by this small p minus Ix. So we will get this I1P is equals to this Ix plus P R divided by P plus Q multiply by I. And in putting the value of I2 in second equation, we will get this I1Q minus value of I2 multiply by Q multiply by small capital I minus Is. Here it should be a I also. Okay. So our I1Q is equals to Is plus of QR divided by P plus Q multiply by total current I. Now solving these two equations, this 3.9 and 3.10, we will divide these two equations, we will get P by Q is equals to X plus P R divided by P plus Q in whole divided by S plus Q R divided by P plus Q. Now, readjusting this equation and taking X in our left hand side, we will have P divided by Q multiplied by S is in addition with R divided by P plus Q multiplied by capital P small q divided by capital Q minus P. So here in this case we will just multiply, take this small q as common, so we will get this ratio P by capital P by capital Q in bracket minus with P by Q. So this term is like we are adjusting it for balancing equation, so this value will get equals, so the term turns out to be zero. So finally the term, whole term in this part will get negligible. So our value X is equals to P by Q multiplied by S. So if the ratio of P by Q is made very nearly equals to small p by Q, then this term will be very small, and if R is also very small, the whole of the second term becomes negligible and the balance simplifies to X is equals to P by Q S, as I already discussed. In this equation it is important of making the two ratios P by Q and small p by Q equal. It may also be used to determine the error in the Calvin's double bridge method. So basically this is the exact equation of Calvin's double bridge method, where we have considered the lead resistance also. But if we are taking the lead resistance as the smallest, or if we are making the ratios exactly equals to each other, then we will have the negligible lead resistance. But if we are not getting the equal ratios of these two, we will be having some kind of error. So for finding that error, we should have this as a correction factor equation. So here in this lecture, we have studied the Calvin's double bridge method, its practical operation of Calvin double bridge method, and we have seen the correction factor of this method. In next lecture we will be going to study the ohmmeter method for the measurement of low resistance. That is the final fourth method for that. For now I'm going to end this video. For any query you can write me. The lecture notes of this whole chapter will be provided in once on the college website. Till then, continue your lectures. Stay healthy, stay safe.